Hello, welcome to The Bright Corner, a place where you can come to hear inspirational stories, sayings, and songs. The name, The Bright Corner, comes from a quote that a friend of mine often says, "Brighten the corner where you are." As the saying implies, you don't need to accomplish huge things. Just handle your little corner. Do your best on any given day to make one person's journey a little easier. Not anything overwhelming, just something bright. This friend of mine, the one who says, "Brighten the corner where you are," is the first inspirational story I want to tell you about. Her name is Miss Bettye. Bettye lives in simplicity. She has no internet, no cable, no running car. She has little in the way of material things, but she is rich in wisdom and spirituality. 4 years ago, my mom and I noticed that Bettye was hobbling around and was in quite a bit of pain. She told us she had fallen in her yard a few weeks before. She assumed the pain in her right leg was related to that fall. Her right breast was also bothering her and was quite swollen. We convinced Bettye to let us take her to an acute care facility. The PA examined Bettye and said without hesitation, "Honey, you've got breast cancer." Later, we would learn that the pain in Bettye's leg was due to a fractured hip. Her bones weakened by cancer cells. Her condition was life-threatening. The PA arranged for Bettye to meet with a surgeon the following day. The biopsy and test revealed stage 4 breast cancer with multiple bone metastases. But God placed a wonderful oncologist and treatment team in her life, and Bettye began chemotherapy immediately, 6 grueling hours every 3 weeks. Once she was somewhat stable, Bettye underwent major orthopedic surgery. She has also had a radical right mastectomy and radiation treatment. Yet, through it all, Bettye never complains. When I pick her up to take her to her appointments, I'll say, "Bettye, how are you today?" Without fail, her response is, "I am blessed and highly favored of the Lord." Bettye says she is honored that God has chosen her for this journey, to be able to inspire others who are facing their own trials. When we arrive at the cancer center, we can expect at least 4 or 5 people to approach Bettye with the words, "Will you pray with me?" Many have heard about her story. She is a source of hope to them. I suppose this would be a good time to note that Bettye is currently in remission. Her last 3 PET scans show no cancer cells whatsoever. During the past 4 years, I have had the honor to spend many hours with Bettye. The more time I spent with her, the more I became convinced that Bettye's sayings and her approach to life should be placed in a book as a way to inspire others. You see, unbeknownst to me, it had always been Bettye's heart's desire to be an author. At the age of 70, God honored that desire in a way that Bettye could never have orchestrated on her own. Through the help of some wonderful and talented friends, Bettye and I have published her meditations and sayings in 2 books. The first book provides hope and inspiration to cancer patients. A second book provides spiritual advice to college students. Both books are available at the Bright Corner website. Let me close by reading one of Bettye's meditations from her first book. "Lord, help us to remember that whatever our struggle, we can reach the end of our journey. The journey may be a single day, a single hour, a single moment or a lifetime. But we can complete each phase of the journey if we remain focused on you. Our victory need not be a major event or accomplishment. Our victory comes from the small things we can take from this journey. The people we bless through our prayers, the ministering angels we meet along the way, the things we learn about ourselves, the ways in which we draw closer to you. Help us to remember that God's love for us is like a deep well. We need only go to the well and draw from it when we want to be replenished. I hope you have been inspired by Bettye's story, and I hope you will visit the Bright Corner again soon.